Between 1898 and 1901, an amazing construction occurred in Western Australia. The emerging metropolitan city of Perth constructed a major reservoir at Mundaring and a 700-kilometer pipeline east to the newly discovered goldfields of Kalgoorlie. This map shows the location of Perth on the Swan River near the Indian Ocean, looking west to South Africa. Mundaring is a tiny community about 35 kilometers east of Perth. Situated about 8 kilometers south of Mundaring is the junction of two rivers, the site of the Mundaring Weir. This 1950 map shows the route of a railway spur that was constructed from Mundaring to the proposed site of the weir in 1900. The railway spur connected with the Eastern Railway, which was constructed in the 1880s east of Perth. The architect of a lot of this construction was C.Y. O'Connor, and here's a statue in honor of him. Let's look at some historical photographs into the construction of the weir, taken between 1898 and the early 1900s. This is the original site of the weir. The spur line was constructed in order to bring in materials and men. Large amounts of dynamite was used to blast out the site. Very early work on the weir. Working conditions were quite primitive in those days. Interestingly enough, the dam was constructed near the flat, not in the usual convex shape. This was because the rocks on the side of the dam were not deemed strong enough to carry the weight of the water. Nearly complete with number one pump house to the left. Building the weir, the back view. Building the weir, the front view. Helena Weir, end view. Here you can see the railway spur that serviced the dam. A view of the reservoir created by the dam. The completed project. In 1950, the dam was raised a further 30-odd feet. This is the construction of the enhanced dam. Now we'll take a look at the pipeline that was to run to Kalgoorlie. It had a series of pumping stations. Number one pump station was located just below the Mundaring Weir Dam, beginning the construction of number one pump station. Building the engine foundation. Installing the boilers to drive the steam pumps. The Babcock Wilcox boilers that were used in the number one pump station. A close-up of the boilers. Another view of the first day's pumping. A engine, number one pump station. Quite a marvelous shot showing the workers. The weir with number one pump house fired up and operating. This panoramic view clearly shows number one pump house with the weir in the background. It must have been a winter's day because the sky looks very threatening. I took this picture from the dam looking down in 2005, showing number one pump house, now a historic museum. Another view from the same location. The front entrance of number one pump house. Laying the pipeline from the weir to Kalgoorlie, it was a major job. Here's what the line looks like today, and it still pumps water to provide the gold city of Kalgoorlie. It has gone through reincarnation, and here are the remains of an older pipeline. The railway was built from the Eastern Railway in Mundaring to Mundaring Weir. This is the Mundaring station on the Eastern Railway, which has been shut for many years. Construction of the weir led to quite a large construction camp, indeed a small town. Ironically, these people are boxing in front of the dancing studio. This is the home of one of the chief engineers on the construction project, built a galvanized iron. The construction camp in many ways looked like the Wild West in the western United States. There was quite a trade in slag grog, that is, homemade alcohol, and a hotel was constructed to service the liquor needs of the workers. It's off to the right. A tranquil view of the weir. Boats are not allowed today. Back in the early days, the weir used to overflow almost every year, and it was a regular occurrence, attracting many tourists. Indeed, these early photographs look very impressive. A view of the overflow with number one pump house. Looking down the spillway from the weir. There used to be regular tourist trains taking picnickers from Perth out to the weir to see the overflow. Another year, another overflow. I think these shots were taken in the 1920s. There's no excess of water like this now. In 1950, the dam was extended higher by another 20 or 30 meters and vastly increased the size of the reservoir. But increasing water consumption means that the dam is never filled. I haven't seen an overflow for at least 15 years. Quite a nice aerial view. The weir today, with the extension, is actually quite a bit higher. and this view of the weir is taken from quite a height. Looking at the weir from beside the dam, it looks very attractive, but you're not allowed to swim or boat or fish. A view of the far side of the weir. We crossed the weir, but when we got to the far side, there was a staircase, so we came back. This is my friend Mark Pillage. The old railway spur is gone, but the remains of the bed can be seen, with the blasted rock on either side. This cutout runs from the dam down to number 1 pump station. Much of the van now.